You're listening to The Metal Experience. Only on Slam Internet Radio.
Woo! As everyone gets settled in here, we just heard some Lamb of God, Laid to Rust, Chimera, Cleanse. Yeah.
You're already
and
failing.
Nevermore, The Hard Collector. We are here today with Threatening the Order. Woo woo! I am Luke O'Blaze with Morgan Danielle. Why don't you guys go ahead and introduce yourselves? Tell us what you do in the band and who's missing.
I'm Ed, guitar player, Threatening the Order.
I'm Melissa, the singer.
And I'm Pete, I play drums.
And Izzy, our bass player, is on his way.
And we'll be here shortly. So is this a full lineup then once Izzy's here, all
yes.
Four of you?
Yep.
Nice. Tell us a little bit about how you guys all met, how long you've been together.
Oh, breaking stuff.
I'm just going to move mine out of the line of fire here. it goes back about 10, 11 years now. I kind of started the band. Izzy came on shortly after, got things going. Been a revolving door of singers and drummers ever since, like most bands. And we've known Melissa on and off for the last couple of years. She came back home, where she belongs. And we met Pete earlier this year, and so this has been the lineup since about May.
Nice. And how did you come into the band, Pete? How did you find these people?
Oddly enough, I actually found them on Craigslist.
Yeah, that's the typical love story between bandmates. Yeah. Apparently, Craigslist is the band's meeting, dating website. So check out Craigslist for those interested in being in a band. There's a lot of great leads on there. So tell us a little bit about the name, Threatening the Order. What does that mean? How did you decide that that was going to be it?
Okay, and I think this is the first time Melissa and Pete are hearing this as well.
Ooh,
you don't even know?
You've been in the band for like how long?
You know, I would like to say that it came to me in a vision, but it didn't.
It sounds cooler that way, right?
So, you know.
How's a fly in here? What the fuck? I apologize. This is weird.
It'll be dead soon. It's way too cold in here for a fly.
You'd hope so.
Like I said, about 10, 11 years ago, we had a band together, and we were focusing on actually making music and not caring about names or image or anything else. And it came time when we were finally going to go start doing something. I was like, we need a name. What the hell are we going to call ourselves? And getting four people to agree on something, not happening. And the singer and I at the time, we were instant messaging back and forth, like, you know, in the middle of the night trying to, you know, bounce and name ideas off each other, shooting the other person's ideas down.
What were some of the bad ones?
I honestly don't remember a lot of the bad ones because they were that bad. And this was a while ago. If you really want bad names, I could go back further. One guy that I played with wanted to call the band Hotsy Totsy.
What is this, a children's group?
Well, with the little Motley Crue dots over the O's.
Wow.
The umlauts.
So, that's retarded.
Yeah. So anyway.
Hotsy Tots.
Yeah. So, you know, back to, you know, the good stuff. And so we're IMing, and I was on my computer, and there was a little shortcut on the desktop to an article my girlfriend at the time, now wife, wrote called Threatening the Order. And I was like, that's the band name.
Did anyone shoot it down?
No.
They were like, all right, that's it. You got it.
Yeah. And although maybe about 6 months later, the singer that had been arguing with me wanted to change the band name after 6 months, and I said no.
Been there. Couple of times.
Well, thank God your wife wrote that article, or you would have never had a band name. You would have landed with Hotsy Totsy.
I'm pretty certain that wouldn't have happened regardless. And, that was a short-lived relationship with that vocalist anyway.
For those that want to call in, we are live. It's 773-657-3341. Again, it's 773-657-3341. We're on for 2 hours, so we're probably going to go to about 10:15 tonight since the show before us ran over. Thank you, Mrs. Gam's Reading Corner, for those awesome books. but do call in, talk with us in the band, and we'll be on for a little bit longer past 10, so you do have some time still. Tell us a little bit then about, you know, over the years you've obviously had some lineup changes and everything. Have you been fully together making music for 10 years? Did you guys take a break?
No, Izzy and I have pretty much kept the candle burning the entire time. You know, reached a point where I just figured we were never going to have a full band. And it was like, you know what? If we're 90 and it's just the two of us jamming in the basement, that's just fine with me.
With banjos.
Yeah. So, yeah, you know, it's just, things fell into place finally.
And what do you think your influence is? Has it changed over the years, or have you guys kept the sound consistent throughout your lineup?
I think the sound's been consistent, but as I've discovered new bands, I've added new things to it. But, you know, as far as my influences go as a guitar player, as a songwriter, you know, Iron Maiden, you know, big influence there. You know, old thrash, Anthrax, Overkill, Iced Earth's probably my favorite band, the biggest impact that's been on me musically. So that's kind of what the core of it all is, at least musically for me. But then, you know, as you discover new bands, Amon Amarth, you know, that sort of thing. And then, you know, I discovered Nightwish a few years back, which kind of changed my mind on having a female vocalist. You know, it was like up until then, you know, it's metal, it's testosterone, you got to have a guy belting it out, growling, you know, whatever. And then I heard that, you know, I just discovered this band that had this, you know, kind of operatic female vocalist going over this pretty cool heavy music. And so I was like, maybe a woman could do it. But we don't do the orchestration, we don't do the symphonic stuff. So it's like, okay, we need, you know, if we're going to go with a female vocalist, we need someone that can just rock. And we found her.
Now, what were your influences as a vocalist before you joined the band, or when did you decide you wanted to be a vocalist?
I've always wanted to sing since I was a little kid. My music taste is pretty open. Oddly enough, one of my biggest influences would be Mariah Carey.
Nice.
And I love her.
It's okay.
I love her. Yay! You know, I listen to a lot of different kinds of music. You know, I've listened like a lot of Hole and stuff when I was younger. Made me kind of realize that, you know, I could be in something more heavy or whatever, and kind of made me seek more of a metal type thing to sing. I don't know. I like all kinds of music. I listen to rap and
are there R&B. Any Mariah Carey covers in the future for Threatening the Order?
No.
And Pete, what about you? What were your influences that got you into the heavy music genre?
Let's see. Obviously, you get one of my biggest influences would have to be Slayer.
Yeah.
Just because, well, I really love playing fast. outside of that, obviously, just like Ed mentioned, once I've gotten to know more bands, the influences kind of grew. And the next biggest one would probably have to be Raymond Herrera from Fear Factory.
Just him?
At least on the drums. Well, obviously, Dino had a lot of
some sick fucking drumming.
Obviously, from there though, Tim Young from Divine Heresy.
Oh yeah.
Essentially, I like to call him the Raymond Herrera and Gene Hoagland kind of. If they had a baby, it would be Tim Young.
It'd be little baby Tim Young.
But yeah, I mean, I've been playing drums for actually crawling almost 2 decades now, and everybody got to start slow, and now I think I'm actually doing pretty good, but there's always room for practice.
No, I think I'm doing all right, I guess.
I think you're doing great, Pete.
Oh, yeah.
You guys actually brought 2 songs with you tonight that you guys are working on recording. They're not quite finished.
Now give us the disclaimer.
Yes.
Okay. These are hot off the presses, just finished recording on Saturday. They're not mixed, they're not EQ'd. There's a lot of work that still needs to be done on the production, but it at least gives you an idea of what we're doing.
And where did you guys record your tracks at, or where are you still working on them at?
That was actually done at Demented Records in Tinley Park.
How did you guys hook up with them?
It was actually many, many moons ago that I recorded with them, with my old band, and he's actually extremely reasonable when it comes to price. So I figure if we're going to do, you know, record a demo, why spend thousands and thousands of dollars where we can just have something, you know, on a budget. And when we actually do put out a full album, then we can invest the money into it.
That makes sense. Well, let's hear the first track that you guys brought. What is that track called?
Oh, I don't have it written down.
Why are you looking like you're ashamed of this track, Michelle? Is this something that we should hear?
She's very shy.
If you never heard this after you recorded it?
Oh, no, she did. She didn't like it then.
Okay, to add to the disclaimer.
The singing's a lot louder than the music.
I'm going to throw another disclaimer on it. We just got this last night.
Yeah,
we rushed it to bring it here. So you guys are the first.
Nice.
Well, now all the listeners are going to be the first.
We'll be with one of many. So what is this first song called?
Dave? This one. I don't remember which disc you have loaded up.
He's got
I wrote them both. So
the first one, Dave.
Okay, Something to Prove.
Okay, so the first song is called Something to Prove.
All right, let's listen to Something to Prove.
Listening to the Metal Experience, only on Slam Internet Radio.
And we're back. We are the Metal Experience. Haven't given this out in a while. We're broadcasting from 4055 North Milwaukee Avenue in Chicago. If you want to come out, you know, stand in front of our great glass window and press your nipples up against them.
Oh, they might get stuck. They might get stuck.
We want to see the little ninja stars. All right. So we're here with...
I've never heard little ninja stars. Is that what the kids are calling nip-nips nowadays?
That's what I'm calling them.
Party hats is old school at this point.
Party, yeah. So I'm Morgan Danielle with a stash full Luco Plays.
The always back. Beautiful, as Dustin says.
Yeah, the always beautiful. That was a great compliment. And I
blushed.
Yeah, it was very nice. We're here with Threatening the Order. We just played their first track for the world to hear.
Disclaimer.
You
want to throw that back?
The freshly recorded, not yet mixed first track.
And that was Something to Prove. So, yes. Michelle, did you write the lyrics for that? Melissa, thank you.
you've been calling her Michelle this whole night.
If anybody ever messes up my name, it's always Michelle. So
yeah, I always get called Megan, so it's okay.
What's your real name?
Okay. What is that song about? Did you write it?
Yes. It's kind of about, like, religion type things and...
It's okay. You can tell us.
You've been calling her Michelle the whole time.
I'm sorry.
It's about when people mess up my name.
I just have something to prove, okay?
I need to prove I'm Melissa, okay? No, just, you know, how people who have certain views about religion may always think they're right about everything and may not necessarily be.
And you guys just have two songs recorded. Is the CD longer? Is it just going to be two songs?
Just two songs for now. Just something to get the name out, something to give out at our upcoming show on December 14th at the Bada Brew.
Be there.
And if you do want a demo, it's for the low price of free.
You just have to come and say hi to one of us.
That's hi. Awesome.
Waiting.
It's at the show.
Nice.
No, but it's guys, it still needs to be mixed.
Could you imagine someone just like hi and you're like, what the fuck?
What are you waiting for? So how has the recording process been? Was this the first time that Threatening the Order ever stepped into a studio?
No, it was the first time though that this lineup has.
Okay. What did you guys do with the old songs? Did you scrap them to start fresh, or are you using those?
We're still using them with some little tweaks here and there. New lyrics, of course, that Melissa has written.
Not Michelle.
Sorry.
Her name is Bob.
Feel so bad. Totally fine.
So no, I tend to not scrap everything. If there's something that I realize I'm not happy with, I keep it in the back of my mind for later on and, you know, maybe reintroduce it, maybe change some things up and that sort of thing. So, yeah, I never throw a riff away.
What is the favorite song that you guys have written so far?
Well, technically, it doesn't have a name for it yet, but we call it the fast one.
The fast one.
The fast one.
Well, you know, that's the thing, you know, kind of going back, sorry, because we'll get to your favorite in a second, Melissa.
They're all my favorite.
So, you know, kind of going back to the, when we didn't have a lineup and it was just Izzy and I, like, I mean, we don't really play covers, so it's just us writing stuff. And we've always had singers that have written the lyrics. I'll confess, I'm a terrible lyric writer. Songs never had titles. So it was the new one, the fast one, the one that's in the drop D tuning, the faster one, the new fast one. That those were kind of our
working
titles.
I love those titles. Those should definitely be the ones that go
all
on
right, guys, this one's called the new faster one. Check it out.
That'd be fun.
Coming soon. Okay, so Melissa, your favorite song?
I don't know. I like them all.
You have to pick one.
Pick one.
The pressure's on.
I don't know. I like
Mariah Carey. So,
yeah.
You're going to be singing them live in front of a bunch of people.
Honestly, I don't like have like a favorite. Like I like them all for different reasons. And
they're all your babies.
They're not
right?
Your children. They're songs.
How many songs do you guys have that you will be playing the set with on the 14th?
The 14th, it's a short set of about 5 songs.
That's not bad.
So I'm not going to force Melissa to pick a song now. My favorite is a song that we have called Casting Molds.
Yeah, no, Melissa's is also the fast one.
Yeah, the fast
because
one.
She hasn't written lyrics for it yet.
Exactly.
I kind of have. In the process. Finished
working
it.
On it.
Yes.
No, you have a 15-year-old. What does he think of mom being in a band?
Mom's a rock star.
He thinks it's cool. He doesn't, you know, he likes more like screaming type of metal. So, you know,
just the fact that you're
it's cool and embarrassing at the same time, I guess. Like
that's just awesome that you're like, my mom is a rock star. what? You tell your friends. Like, that's awesome.
She's wearing my Dying Fetus hoodie as you speak.
Yeah.
My mom, shout out to Alex.
My mom is wearing my Dying Fetus. That funny story
on
behind
a radio
that.
Show.
Funny story behind that. What was the funny... How did you acquire this Dying Fetus?
That looks brand new, by the way.
It looks brand new.
It looks even newer. I mean, you can wear it. My husband found it at the park. And he had no idea what it was and brought it home.
What dumbass kid lives their Dying Fetus
at
the park?
It's just so, I mean, how often, it's, you know, you pick up a hoodie, it would be, like you were saying, I don't know.
Abercrombie.
Old Navy.
Old Navy. But what are the odds that you pick it up and it's Dying Fetus? Like, that's like hitting the lottery.
For like one of his friends to be like, hey, that's my hoodie. Or, you know, because how many people like listen to that?
Yeah, I mean, anybody can say anything, honestly. And you can be like, I found it first.
No, my mom bought it for me.
No,
from the park.
Finders keepers.
Yeah, that's the rule. Now, do any of you guys have kids?
Not a one.
Not yet.
So now, you don't have the rock star status.
Do you
yet,
let your son wear his Dying Fetus hoodie to school?
Yes.
They don't. You know what? The best part of it is they probably can't read it, so they don't say anything.
That's the best part.
Now it says it on the back more clearly, but I try to have him not wear the hood.
Well, I don't think you can wear hoods in schools.
They're more worried about like gang colors and stuff, so I don't think.
Not Dying Fetus hoodie.
Well, at least on the upside, it's not a Cannibal Corpse t-shirt.
Yeah, those are grotesque. Lugo probably wore those in high school.
I did wear those in
high
school.
I don't know how you got away with it.
I just, I would walk in the, you know, with my my books in front of my shirt.
Actually, funny story, I got my buddy a friend, I got my buddy a shirt for Christmas that was, I forget what it was. It was Dead Girls Don't Say No. Oh, Cradle of Filth.
Cradle of Filth. There you go.
He got away with wearing that every day, almost every day in school. He loved that shirt.
I wore an old style jacket every day to school, and I put my books in front of the logo. So
they probably thought you were hungover every single day.
I mean, I was.
Well, now that we got you to talk, Dave. Hey, it's your segment. And by the way, happy birthday!
Happy birthday, Mofo!
Happy birthday, Dave.
We gave him a Crumb Bums t-shirt.
It's a Crumb Bums of a dog taking a shit.
It's definitely like it's like
a very
it's not,
great birthday gift to give.
Not
someone.
A shirt you'd wear to school type of. Yeah, like it's literally a circle with a dog pooping.
By the way,
it says Crumb Bums.
That is your 2-year anniversary. This marks Dave's 2 years with our
That's
show.
Right. Two years and your birthday.
Thank you for just tuning knobs and pushing play.
That's pretty much what I do.
And answering the phones and accidentally hanging up on people.
Hanging up on people and then also playing songs that don't play and cutting people off in the middle of stuff and shutting microphones off. And
yep.
Saying bands that we have no idea who the fuck you're talking about.
Being our translator sometimes.
Translator.
Yeah.
Looking up Guar videos.
Definitely.
This is his job. Every Tuesday night.
Yeah. So did you guys ever check out that other band we played last week, World's Scariest Police Chasers?
What happened to your sweeper? You can't talk without the sweeper.
Oh, just all right.
Let's hear it from the soundboard.
That sweeper is your sign that you
talk.
Can speak. Correct. So now, hey, what have you not checked out?
No, did you check out that band from last week, World's Scariest Police Chasers?
We have not yet.
Actually, I found one of their songs on YouTube.
Oh, look how excited he is.
No, it was
great. Well, because it's your birthday, I guess we can play it. If you want to play some of this. Oh, wait, you did play some of this for us where it was ridiculously lyriced for arresting people.
Even a punk band?
Yeah, exactly. So play it again for the world to hear. World's Scariest Police Videos. That's the name of the band, correct?
World's Greatest Police Chases, yeah.
World's Greatest. Okay, that's totally opposite of what I was saying. I'm fucking up names left and right tonight, folks. I do apologize.
When is that different from normal?
That's true. Dave's
it's
so
even
witty.
Worse, though.
Well, what do you got for us, Dave?
All right, really quickly. Bouncing Souls announced their Home for the Holidays show at the Stone Pony.
Where's that?
It's actually out in New Jersey. Albert Park, New Jersey. But we had a band send us stuff from Israel today, so I try to report on anything going on like in the States and even worldwide, because we like having stuff sent to us from France and New York, South Africa.
How dare you?
What?
I don't know.
Chile, Slovenia, yeah.
All bunch of crazy places.
Yeah.
I mean, not crazy, but
well, it's still nuts to get it all out there.
All right, we're all nuts to get it all out there. So what do you got to do?
Anyway,
gotta get your nuts out somewhere.
Yeah, right?
Yep.
I hope you guys are ready. Riot Fest is already announcing early bird tickets for 2014.
I did see that today. It would be nice to know a lineup first before I bought tickets, but...
If you looked in their Twitter, like, somebody actually asked the guy who runs their Twitter, like, can I get a lineup? It's not only no, but fuck no.
Oh, shit. Oh, there you go. There's a there's
well,
a
way,
way
to be polite and...
Well, they're, I don't know if you saw it last year. Did you see they had a John Stamos butter statue?
What?
That sounds... Do you have pictures?
Yeah, I can look it up.
Did you make sandwiches
did
with it?
People no, take knives to it? Spread it on bread like you're supposed to with John butter?
Who's like, you know what? You know what Riot Fest needs? A John Stamos statue made out of butter.
Why wasn't it like Danzig or something or Squar or somebody else?
Here's a bunch of pictures.
That's butter, Dave.
No, this is John Stamos.
Click on it. Like, I can't see it.
You're so far away from us. This glass is foggy, full of our body heat that's...
Well, and heavy breathing now that we're looking at John Stamos.
Right? Yeah.
Especially made out of butter.
Okay.
So you just took it off the screen? No.
I gotta click on the. I gotta click on the image first, and I'll put it back.
Oh, people can see what we're saying. That looks like Prince.
That looks like Michael Jackson.
That's not John Stamos. That's
what they
Prince.
Said. It was the John Stamos butter statue.
Nope, they do not know what John Stamos looks
they
like.
They obviously early John Stamos. Seen John Stamos's beautiful jawline.
I mean, he's missing a pupil. Like there is just there's it's, one
it
eye.
It could have just melted.
I don't think a hole melts.
Yeah, that's weird looking. That's, okay. Well, thanks for pulling that up, Dave. Anything else? You just want to talk about John Stamos butter statues.
Well, because they're... Yeah, I don't know. It was weird enough that I found it. So, anyway, yeah, I'll get rid of that.
No, leave it up.
Please try to redeem yourself from that. That was pretty terrible.
What the fuck is this John Stamos butter statue?
It's not John Stamos.
Yes, it was.
I didn't.
According to everybody else at Riot Fest.
Well, apparently, according to everybody else at Riot Fest, no one has seen what John Stamos looks like.
Well, I think early John Stamos anyway.
Nope.
You mean Uncle Jesse?
Yeah.
Uncle Jesse.
Uncle Jesse and the Rippers?
Way to make me
and
feel
the Rippers,
old.
Yes.
All right, continue, Dave. Didn't you have a song or something?
I'm trying to find the songs. Like finding the track was almost impossible the other time. But anyway, I'll keep going and like cutting back to my YouTube search. Super 7-inch giveaway today at Fat Records. There was four EPs were actually announced. The Flatliners, Caskets Full, NOFX is another EP. Stoke Extinguisher, the Swingin' Udders.
That's five.
Yeah, that's more than four.
No. That's the name of the album afterward.
You said it like it
was. Flatliners' album, his name is Caskets Full.
Oh.
NOFX is called Stoke Extinguisher.
Oh.
Swingin' Udders announced their album, Stuck in a Circle. And the funniest one, I think, is Teenage Bottle Rocket, American Deutsch Bag.
Oh, there you go. There you go.
I was a teenage Deutsch Bag.
No. Oh.
All right, go no. Stand in the corner.
Okay, some big names were announced at next year's Download Festival. The
Where's
Offspring.
That?
Download Festival is actually over in. Fuck.
Over in fuck.
Over in fuck.
Is it yep. England?
I believe so.
Damn it.
Anyway.
So we got The Offspring?
Offspring, Linkin Park, Avenged Sevenfold, Fall Out Boy, Bless the Fall. And
they suck.
Okay.
Trivium. I just saw them. They were terrible.
Trivium in Flames. Whew. And let's see, where was I here? Black Dahlia Murder,
it's
Miss
like
May
all
I.
All the bands going down except for Miss May I. All the bands.
Dying Fetus is playing.
Oh, there you go.
We just saw
on
them.
On the up and up.
They're.
We just saw them, yeah, a couple weeks ago.
And sad news, Lemmy.
Has died?
No.
No. Lemmy cannot die.
I'm surprised all that alcohol
mold,
hasn't killed him.
His
yet.
Mold grew another human being?
Nah, just kidding. Anyway, he has no quote. He has no plans to retire and is actually working on a solo album.
Oh my god!
Why would you work on a solo album when he is Motorhead?
Because
yeah.
he can't.
Part.
He's Lemmy.
He might as well just call himself Lemmy and the Motorheads,
or just Motorhead. I mean, when you're like, oh yeah, Motorhead. There's Lemmy, and then there's that Mexican drummer dude, and then there's
that
white dude guitarist, and I don't know their names, but.
Well,
if I ever saw him on the street, I wouldn't recognize him.
If you ask those people, like, oh, you into, are you in the Motorhead? Yeah, what's your favorite song? Ace of Spades? That's
the Ace of Spades.
That's all anyone
that's
can ever name.
That's the only thing anybody knows. What? Because they're not that great.
Wow.
I can't stand his voice. You know, what's funny is though when I saw him in Mayhem, I actually knew, like, six songs. I was like, that's Motorhead? Whatever. Continue.
Okay. Anyway, let's see. Band Lionheart announces the new album, Welcome to the West Coast. Anyone know them? No?
Nope.
Anyway, Vans Warped Tour lineup.
July 19th, yeah. Bitches. Yeah,
you already know that.
Hell yeah. I was there when the lineup for the dates got announced. So, yup.
Well, I don't know.
I like how you're so excited, but it's like.
Hey, Warped Tour is a blast. And we were going to go last year, but I had already bought Mayhem Fest.
Not every festival has reverse daycare.
That's true. I should bring my mom.
Do you not know what reverse daycare
oh,
is?
Oh, yeah, remember where they just had all the old people in a tent?
Yeah, well, with, like, air conditioning, I'm assuming, and a TV.
Video games and TV and lounge couches and everything. It's a pretty awesome setup, if you ask me. I mean,
well, yeah,
because
if you're, like, 10 or 11 and go into Warped Tour and you don't
want to
go. You
shouldn't be wandering around there alone. There are some dangerous things around there.
Like what? Don't they search everybody?
Just people. Dangerous
I don't know.
Humans.
Like a bunch of, like...
People named Dave walking around.
Nothing to see here. Move along. Yeah.
I've been to Warped Tour a few times. It's actually like really unimpressed. And then when I saw Jeffree Star was in the lineup a few years ago, I don't want to go no more.
No, Jeffree Star is pretty nasty.
I don't know who that is, but okay.
All right.
And he partnered with Blood on the Dance Floor for some stuff. And
yeah,
then
that's
they're
nasty.
Even worse.
And Hollywood Undead. Believe that one. It's pretty gross.
Yeah, cool story.
And with Deuce when he released an album.
Oh,
yeah.
Speaking of creepy people, yeah, there's still a petition to get Blood on the Dance Floor off Warped Tour in their entirety.
That's hilarious.
Or how about just making the band break up in general?
Yeah, that's
they're
cool,
terrible.
Too.
Can
but
you
I'd
force a band to disband?
Unless
like it was
just don't buy their tickets. If you don't show up to the show, they can't continue.
Or just egg their tour bus. Either way.
Continue.
Devil Wears Prada, frontman releases book, Home for Grave.
Yeah, he was selling that at the show. I don't know what it's about. I don't know if I want it, but continue.
Why wouldn't you want
to
buy it?
I don't know. It was weird. I kind of tried to read what it was about, and I was like, eh.
Whatever. I read it and I was like, I don't know what that means. So I put it down and walked away like
it's kind of like a,
I don't know.
It's kind of like an autobiography, I'm assuming, or a biography about himself.
It was like Jimmy grabs this apple from a tree and chucks it across
no,
the
I
street.
No, I seriously
then he goes
think
home
he
and
wrote
hangs
a fiction
out
book.
Video
I think
games.
It's a fiction book.
Please, video games. I don't know.
It
was
right,
what
here
I
we
could
go.
Tell.
The story behind the song, Home for the Grave, tells a tale of Ian.
I don't. What else you got? I don't need the whole description of this like 20-page little pamphlet book.
It's $10.
Yeah.
$10
and
it's and like,
it was super skinny. I could probably get that thing at half price book for $3.
If you can find it there. I don't think anybody's traded it in yet.
Because it's basically like
buy
three
it off
pieces
Amazon
of paper.
For $3. Whoever
anyway,
has
Dave,
it,
what else
sell
you got?
It to me for $3.
that was actually
it.
My last bit, and I did find the track again.
All right, let's hear a little bit of snippet of World's
Scariest
police videos, and then we'll hear
Chase,
some more.
Chases.
Whatever.
Parking in a crosswalk, citizens arrest. Holy crystal meth lab, citizens arrest. I thought I saw those kids smoking weed behind the tool shed. I think we'll have to confiscate that. Pull you over.
Happy birthday, Dave!
They kind of sound like NOFX a little bit.
Well, that's the name of the album. No Effects, Out Come the Wolves, and I can't read that last part.
So it's like No Effects and Rancid meets what?
I guess
oh,
so.
Yeah, Green Day, right? You said Dookie?
Yeah, No Effects and Out Come the Wolves, Dookie.
You guys remember when Green Day was good? Yeah, me either.
Shut up.
I fucking hate Green Day.
You're a loser.
Well, no. They were good right before they actually formed the band.
There you go. As human beings, they were, I guess, all right before they formed the band.
Guys are
stupid. I absolutely hate
I was
going to
say
Day.
Before.
I'm on the record over the internet. I hate Green Day.
popular answer I was going to say is before Nimrod came out and then they sucked.
Before they made any music, they were terrible.
I like them. Leave me alone.
You have terrible taste in music.
I was like, what the hell is that? When, Story of Your Life or whatever? Most overused song, I think. What is it called? Like,
Dave, no one knows.
What?
I don't listen to Green Day.
No, Morgan should know. Like,
wake me up when September ends.
Maybe that's it.
Oh God, I hate that song.
That is definitely not Story of Life. What? You don't know your Green Day, son.
When that song would come on the radio, I'd punch my radio.
It's the perfect transition. Holiday into Boulevard of Broken Dreams.
All right, awesome. No one gives a rat's ass. Let's move on. Man, I hate Green Day one more time. I just want to put that out there.
Well, the band brought some more music to play. Dave, are you done talking?
Yeah, that's
okay.
It.
Okay.
Thanks, so finally. Jeez, happy birthday, dickweed.
Let's go ahead and play a couple songs that you guys brought on that CD. So think of what's on it and what do you want to hear?
Well, why don't we play D-Manufacture from Fear Factory?
Boom. Good
and
choice.
Get one more.
I like that
so
band.
Fear Factory. And I know like that we had a mention of Hole earlier. How about we play that Hole song?
What Sweet. Hole? Dave? There's a Hole song on there?
There's a Hole yes. song on there. What is
I,
that one
what
called?
If I just want to hear half of it?
What?
The Hole one is She Walks on Me.
I would have preferred Ooh. Something older, but we didn't have a chance.
We can look it up on the
Well, let's play the Fear Factory song, then you can tell Dave what you want to hear, and then we'll play Hole after Fear Factory.
Which is a first. We've never played Hole, which is very weird.
Nice. Here we go. Dave?
The CD's acting up again.
I like
oh
Hole.
My God.
I like Hole better than I like
everything.
Green Day. I'll put that out there, too.
Oh, good.
You're damn right I do.
And I like Mariah Carey more than I like Hole and Green Day.
Sweet.
Loser.
What are you talking about? Mariah Carey's the
No,
shit.
I meant Luco. Loser.
We'll be right back. Listening to the Metal Experience, only on Slam Internet Radio.
And we're back. We're the Metal Experience,
and we're black. And
what? No, we're not. I'm Morgan Daniel with Luke O'Blaze, and we've been sitting here playing some music and discussing things with Threatening the Order. Before we talk a little bit more about the band, we've just had a phone call. A few months ago, we chose This Divided World as an unsigned band pick of the week from New York, and we have on the line the one and only.
Yes.
This is the Metal Experience. You are on air.
Hello, this is Micah Brill.
Hello, Mike. How are you today?
Good.
Now, we are introducing again This Divided World. You guys have just released a EP. Give us a little bit about it, and then you guys did email some songs over for us to go out tonight listening to some of the new recordings that you guys have made.
Yeah, absolutely. So, last time I called and talked to you guys, it was probably like not quite a year ago, but we had just put out a full-length album. It was me and another guy, studio band, and then in the couple months following, the vocalist had basically gone to do his own thing, and so I had this EP written, so I had the idea to get all these different guest vocalists.
That's awesome.
So that's what this EP is. It dropped just about a month ago, and it's 6 tracks. And each of the songs, like I wrote all the music, I went down to Tennessee this summer and recorded all the tracks. But then each of the songs has a different vocalist. They wrote the lyrics and I kind of worked with them back and forth on it.
Nice.
There's, a couple signed bands on there, or vocalists, represented. So I'm really happy with it. It's kind of a crazy EP. Usually, we're featuring this guest vocalist. Well, this is like, it's all guest vocalists, So it's a cool little thing.
Well, that's badass, man. And how long did it take you to record it?
The process when I was in Tennessee, it took 2 days. It was like 2 crazy days. Get there at like noon the first day. I worked until 2 a.m. And then the second day, I think it was like noon until midnight or so. Because, I'm from New York, driving to Tennessee, got to pay for a hotel and all that. So we just slammed through it. It was just me and his name's Maya of the Sound Lair in Knoxville, Tennessee. He actually is the guy that recorded the debut Whitechapel album.
Nice.
And nowadays he works with bands like Itchion and stuff like that. It's kind of his big band, I Devour.
That's awesome.
So he knows what he's doing. So,
did I read correctly that the new CD is already sold out?
Yeah, exactly. Well, I did a limited run of hard copies, just 100. It was super limited. Each one I hand signed them and hand numbered them.
Wow.
They sold out. I had about half of them were already spoken for, because this summer basically, I was looking at, you know, anything I do, I don't want to do cheap. So I'm looking at, you know, thousands and thousands of dollars, you know, on this bill. And I'm like, how am I going to pay for this? Well, I don't know if you guys know about the crowdfunding thing, Indiegogo, or there's also...
Yeah, we did promote that for you, that you raised all the funds to record and everything for that.
Yeah, that's right. Thank you, guys. So, yeah, I ended up getting quite a chunk of money from that. But some of those, some of the things that I promised were hard copies of the EP. So, you know, those ones were already spoken for, and then the rest of them sold out. You know, I gave a few to friends and, you know, just sent them out and stuff like that. So, yeah, they're gone, and I don't plan on doing another run, you know, anytime soon. If I did something with a label sometime in the future and they wanted me to do another run, you know, obviously I would do that. But making CDs is not cheap, and recording's not cheap, as I'm sure, you know, the guys, right, any band says, especially the people there in threatening order, you know, just do the, you know, pay for the demo, get it out there, but then, you know, pay the money for the full-length stuff.
Well, absolutely. Well, thank you so much for the update. We look forward to playing the tracks at the end of the show for the world to hear the new This Divided World. And we'll definitely keep a lookout for the next recordings that you do and keep promoting the music that you guys have written already.
Awesome. Thank you guys for having me. I appreciate it.
Yep. Absolutely.
And you can also find your band and every band that has been featured on the Hey, Look What I Found on the Metal Experience website. I've been working my ass off on it. So every band that's been featured on the Hey, Look What I Found now has a link leading to their website and everything. So you can check that on the Metal Experience right now, man.
Awesome. Thank you.
No problem.
Have a great night.
All right. You guys too. Thanks.
All right. We're back with Threatening the Order. Thank you guys so much for waiting. Pretty cool to have other bands calling an update from around the country and around the world. It's pretty awesome. So what do you guys have planned after the December 14th
show? We have a new member who joined
us. Oh, we do. Sorry. He's sitting right next to me. My peripherals aren't working correctly. So
all them peripherals.
Go ahead and introduce yourself.
Hi, I'm Izzy. I play bass.
I don't think your mic's on, bro.
Take two.
Testing.
You're on live with Izzy.
Hi, I'm Izzy. I play bass for Threatening the Order.
And we've missed some of these questions before from you not being here, so let's refresh ourselves here. For your influences as a bassist, what got you into metal?
Well, it got me into metal. I grew up listening to a lot of early sleaze and cock rock. I grew up with
cock rock?
Yes.
Nice. Is that mic on? Are you sure?
Hello?
Maybe he belongs put in it Hottie right. Hottie.
Maybe you are a bassist. You are the bassist. I can't hear shit. Put that bad boy right up to your mouth. Yeah.
The microphone.
Oh, hey. Oh yeah.
Ooh la la. Feel the bass.
Dave's trying to get a good look at you over here.
Dave's running over and zipping his pants.
Peeking over the computer board.
Dave's getting hot and bothered.
Why are you breathing so heavy, bro?
Hi, Dave.
He's blushing.
My job
birthday,
here is done. Thank you. Thank you.
All right, I'll see you guys later.
We hired you the male stripper you ordered. His name's Izzy.
I'm delicious.
We have the entertainment all night. All right, back to your cock rock.
Hey, I grew up with Motley Crue, Kiss, and all that fun stuff. And I slowly discovered Slayer, Metallica, Megadeth, and that evolved into some of the heavier bands in the late 90s, like Machine Head, Chimera, stuff like that. Trying to think what else. Typo Negative, huge influence on me.
It's okay, take your time. Got all night.
Sweet.
Best response ever.
Well, it's funny watching Metalocalypse and just trying to compare myself to Murderface and just like standing behind the amp like, oh, he's just the bass player.
Do you play the bass with your penis?
I've been working on it, believe it or not.
There you go.
I don't know what to say to that. That's the most awkward transition to go into.
I like how that's the first thing I thought of. Hey, man, you play bass with your penis? Hey, I just met you 2 seconds ago, but how was your wiener playing bass?
I already sold them out to Dave, so I mean, how can it get any weirder? Well, you're talking about, I don't know if you remember when you and Ed were trying to figure out new names for Threatening the Order. What were you thinking for name wise, what was like some of the choices? What was the
worst name?
The worst name you could think of.
What was the worst name?
Besides Hottie Daddy.
Would that be Natural Disaster?
Oh, I forgot about that one. Sorry. I told him about Hotsy Totsy.
Whoa.
Hotsy Totsy, there we go.
Whoa.
You've been hiding that one from me.
You forgot about that one, too.
Well, it's like one of those things, like, what do you call yourself? All the cool names have been taken. You can't call yourself Metallica or whatnot. It's already been taken. And what would you call yourself to give yourself a proper name? So that's always been a
Slayer with two A's.
Slayer.
Slayer.
That'd be perfect. So you guys recorded two songs. What was that process for you like?
It was a lot of fun. I enjoyed it. Like, I've been playing with Ed since many, many years. And whatever he does, I can pretty much follow in sync with him. So we just went in there. We slammed it out. We had a great time. It was a lot of fun.
Did you guys learn anything about yourselves as you recorded that you didn't know before?
I learned I really love macaroni and cheese. Like, what? What?
As far as, like, what we learned from the recording process, you just got to have a lot of patience because there's when you're on, and when you're not, there is a lot of downtime.
I learned I need to use thinner strings on one of my guitars.
Thunder strings?
Thinner.
Oh.
thunder strings also would be pretty
sweet. I have thunder strings now, and they're a bit too heavy.
And in total, how long did you spend recording the two songs?
About 8 hours, close to.
Roughly, yeah.
Yeah, and that included setting up and tuning and everything else.
That's not bad. So are you planning on going back and using the studio again for other EPs, or was this just to get the one out and then you're going to look around for the next one?
You know, this is for now just to get something out, to give away, get our name out there, build up a bit of a fan base, hopefully. You know, the way I'm feeling, you know, I want to go record the album now. You know, so Melissa, write more lyrics.
And the pressure's on. Do you guys have any merch that you guys have released yet over the years?
Not at the moment.
Nothing.
Working on it.
This is the longest lineup we've ever had that was stable. So it's like, oh crap, we need merch now.
Now, what about upcoming shows besides the 14th? Have you guys booked anything past that?
Nope.
So we're just full of answers.
Is the 14th the first show for Threatening the Order, or the first show with this lineup?
With this lineup.
Okay.
Yep.
Now, have you guys...
See, not everything's a no.
Yeah. See, have you guys been in other bands before?
Yes. Many, many bands. I would say... Oh, hey, there we go. This actually works a lot better. I would say altogether, this is probably my 15th or 16th band.
What?
You've been busy.
Yeah, I used to be known as a band whore.
You whore.
Are you actually playing music?
He hasn't taken his pants off from it yet. So.
Not yet. But I'm not going to say anything about my other bands, though.
Okay. Now, you said you came over from, when we were outside, you said you came over from Poland in 95.
Yes.
Were there any? You don't have a Polish accent.
I don't?
No.
I don't know. I guess it's all from, you know, listening to the music that I listen to, which you can barely understand, and watching the movies.
I don't know how that helped you with learning the language.
Trust, I have no idea either.
Well. Okay, and what about some of the bands over there? Did you listen to metal when you were in Poland that influenced you, or did you just...
Essentially, when I was in Poland, I would definitely have to thank my uncle because he essentially got me hooked onto metal with Iron Maiden, Metallica.
Now I think you're just trying to speak Slayer. Polish now, because now I'm starting to pick up on a little accent.
You big faker!
I mean, when I was in Poland. But no, I was mostly just like Slayer, Metallica, Megadeth, Iron Maiden. That's essentially what I grew up in Poland with.
That's awesome. Now, what was the best concert you guys have ever attended?
Tough one.
You guys are all staring December at each 14th other and me.
Coming
like...
up.
Yeah, it hasn't happened yet. For me, it's probably the early Iced Earth shows that I went to, like when they were still playing bars, like in the mid to late 90s.
For me, recently, or about 2 years ago, Rammstein at the Allstate Arena.
Oh, nice. Those are always totally. Awesome.
That was ridiculously
Did you go
awesome.
To both?
No, years? No, I went to the first one, which was,
when
I want to say, 3
came
years
back
ago?
After, like,
their first time after, like, 87 years they were back. Yeah. And one of my favorite shows that I hold close and dear to my heart was at the No, it was at the Riviera Theater. Slipknot opened up for Machine Head and Cold Chamber.
Wow.
Cold Chamber. Woo!
That was a ridiculous show. Just to see them on the stage.
Is your chin speaking into the microphone?
You told me to keep it on my face. That was our supposed to
She do. Wasn't talking about the microphone with that.
Not literally.
Good times for me. No, but it's fun to see like the way Slipknot has this ridiculously large production now, and to see them back in the day as an opener, just raw on stage, no frills, just beating the hell out of everyone.
No, I wish I would have seen Slipknot in their prime. I caught them like after All Hope Is Gone came. Oh, man. All right. We're still missing two voices. The best concert.
There's a lot of good concerts. I would say the one that stands out in my mind would have to be the, I would say, last free Ozfest in Tinley Park.
Oh, that one was awesome. I was there.
Well, it's not for the fact of, obviously, the amazing bands that were there, but after the show, me and two of my buddies, we actually ended up hanging out with Cataclysm. We went out for drinks, we went out for pizza, and we got literally shit-faced.
Nice.
Well, my favorite would be KMFDM just because they've been my favorite forever and ever, and it was my first time seeing them, so it was fucking awesome.
When was that? Was that just recently?
Yeah, at House of Blues.
My brother went to those shows. I'm so jealous.
A friend of mine, actually, me and her, we snuck into the VIP party with KMFDM back at the House of Blues many, many years ago.
What?
Back when Raymond Watts was still in the band.
Lucky sons of bitches.
That was awesome. It was a good time, and Raymond Watts is ridiculously tall. I came up
That's
to his navel.
That's what I've heard.
His navel.
That's a little weird. I can't imagine that height difference then, because he must be giant.
Yes. Yes, he is.
So coming up for you guys, after you guys play on the 14th, what are the plans? Are you guys planning on going back to record the rest of the album?
I think eventually, you know, we'll finish more songs, more lyrics. And, you know,
no
try,
pressure.
Try to get a, you know, get a few more shows under our belt.
And how did people contact you if they were interested in playing shows with you guys and helping promote you or wanting to keep an eye out for the merch and the new songs that you'll be releasing?
At Facebook.com/threateningtheorder.com.
And we have a phone call. Dave, go ahead and patch him through. You're on with the Metal Experience, and who are we speaking with?
Greg.
Greg. Oh, Greg.
I
like how it was just a Greg.
I really wanted to go to that KMFDM show. I'm really ticked off I didn't go.
It was awesome.
Are you just calling to say how much you wanted to go to the show?
This is Webmaster Craig. He has something to say about every band that comes on. So tonight is about KMFDM, or is it about Threatening the Order?
Greg.
Listen. The best show I went to, I think, would be a KMFDM show when they with
Are you Stone Man?
That was a good show.
I'll take that as a yes.
Really nice.
I feel like you might have just woke up, or you're really baked right now. Both.
No.
Wake and bake.
No.
I was in the front of the pit at that show with Kobe Christ, and I had all the guys from Kobe Christ sweat all their nasty makeup all over
me. Oh, God.
Oh,
delicious.
That was a good show, wasn't
it? It was a great show.
Yes.
Craig wanted that sweat all over his body.
Yeah, that was a pretty epic show right there.
Got anything else for us, Craig? Anything? Or just wanted to tell us how awesome?
You guys suck. That's something for you.
Well, thanks, Greg. Thanks for calling in.
Greg,
and
how about thanks for all the hard work that you've been doing on the website?
Yeah, man. Guy.
It's turning out fucking awesome.
It's all Luco, you know. He's just
yeah, but you're the one.
It's because I literally have to stand over Greg's shoulder and tell him everything, and he goes, "You motherfucker! You want to change that? You motherfucker!"
I wish you were recording it all.
Stupid code with commas. You like put a comma in the wrong spot. spot, it like screws it all up. It's crazy.
So since Greg's flying through everything, I just watch him. I'm like, Greg, you put a count that's supposed to, you know, that's wrong. And he'll be like, oh, thanks for watching. But then I'm like, I want changes. Like, you motherfucker.
Greg, I gotta say though, I don't think I'm good enough for him anymore because all he talks about is how much time he wants to spend with you.
Greg, I literally never want to leave your house. I just want to
keep
working
like,
on the website.
Oh, I wish I was working on the website right now. I'm like, thanks. You don't want to spend time with me. You just want to go with Greg.
Yeah.
So apparently you two are dating now. Congratulations. You've
hey,
inherited
boyfriend.
A new boyfriend.
I'm honored.
Say hi to the puppies for me.
Oh, God.
I'll be back soon.
Hey, but I'm going to go and let you guys get back to your thing.
Well, all right, Greg. Well, talk to you later.
All right, see ya.
That escalated quickly.
Oh, man. Every time Greg calls in, he's just like, ugh.
Hey, guys.
Hey. Like Greg, that. What are you doing? Oh. It's like
that one time. Right, that was awesome, man. Yeah.
Man, KMFDM, they were so good, right?
Yeah,
guys?
That was awesome.
All right. Well, we've got an unsigned band pick, as usual, queued up for you, and that's all thanks to Luco.
I guess.
Dave, that's a cue,
that's
by the way.
That's what Dave!
I know 2 years,
you still can't get it right.
I try my best, because sometimes
don't talk,
hates
just
me.
Play Sweet
You're mashed.
Any minute now. Yep. This
Come
this
on,
can
Dave.
Happen.
Now it's time for...
Hey, man, look Come what I found. Here.
Only hey, on man. The Metal Experience.
What? This week we got from Haifa? Was it?
Haifa, yeah.
Haifa and Krayak Israel, the band Catastrophe.
Ooh.
Crazy stuff, right? With the songs Channels and Truth of Creation. Take a listen. Dave.
Switch it.
listening to The Metal Experience. Only on Slam Internet Radio.
Woo! And that was Kastroff from Haifa and Krayat Israel with the songs Channels and Truth of Creation. Check them out. And, well, see you later.
All right, we're back. We're sitting with Threatening the Order, and we have been for the past hour and a half. And we're going to be on for about another 45 minutes just talking with the band. And you guys did bring another track. Disclaimer?
Just recorded. Still needs mixing. Still needs quite a bit of EQ. But we brought it here for everyone to enjoy.
Very awesome. What is the second track called that you guys brought with you today?
This song is called Soul Inside.
Right, Dave, you heard it. Soul Inside, we want to play it.
Listening to The Metal Experience, only on Slam Internet Radio.
And we're back. We are The Metal Experience with a very creaky truck outside that I have no idea what the fuck it's trying to do, but that's okay, because we're in a window on 4055 North Milwaukee Avenue, and you can come say hi to us.
Staring
like I
at
said,
the beautiful Dave.
Feel free to press your nipples up against the cold window to show Dave what you're working with. And
hey, Dave. Here are my nipples.
Happy birthday. Here's my nipples.
You know, I thought about doing that when I walked here, but I'm like, no, it's too cold.
They might stick. So
the puppies are staying in.
take your own risk for that. I got a terrible image in my head right now.
I have wonderful images in my head.
But we just heard the second unmastered track, but recording from Threatening the Order. Thank you guys so much for asking somebody to hustle over those tracks as fast as they could last night. What was that second track called?
It was called Soul Inside.
Soul Inside. And what was that song about?
Just, you know, evil people who are in control of everything type of thing.
A soul that's inside.
That makes sense. Self-explanatory. I get it. Okay. So we were talking a little bit during the break about your most embarrassing live moments, and I've heard a couple of them, and wowee.
wow.
So Melissa better be trying to top one of those during the show on the 14th. Or not, you know, but make it memorable. So let's start with Izzy. Your most embarrassing stage moment was?
Well, it wasn't embarrassing for me. We were playing. So, you know, boys will be boys. We were roughhousing before the show. Former guitar player decides to try to tackle me. He's around my waist. I turn around, I grab his head, and I drive him head first into the concrete.
Oh my gosh.
And then, unbeknownst to Ed, he didn't know he was hurt, so he puts him in a camel clutch.
Nice.
And I'm like, dude, he's really hurt. Get off of him.
He needs medical attention.
And there's a giant knot on his forehead. He didn't know where he was. It was entertaining.
So did he forget the songs to play during set?
We don't need to get into his abilities.
Boy.
Let's just say a week later, we disbanded.
So this is the band that leaves everybody with amnesia. All right. Well, good luck on the 14th. Yeah. All right.
In our defense, we really didn't like the guy very much, so we kind of didn't have a problem hurting
right,
him.
So
we
make
like
sure
Pete
that
Melissa.
They like you, Melissa. Or,
we like Melissa. We like
you Pete. Might not remember who you are the next morning.
Oh, shit.
Maybe if we, you know, drink afterwards.
You might not remember where you are.
You could convince her that her name's Michelle.
That's true. That's
your
true.
Name
your
is
your
Michelle.
Name is Michelle. You
I'm
going to
go for Bob.
Very, very drunk.
Your name is Bob.
All right, next.
All right, well, this was actually my very first show many, many years ago. As
a
I was
lot
playing,
of manis all the time.
Yeah.
Pete's been
manis.
Around.
I've been around.
He thinks so.
Well, he said it was a band whore. So
yeah.
That's true. That's true.
I used to be a band whore. But
a
my
lot
first
of
show.
Drumsticks.
Well, my first show, I was playing drums, obviously. And I ended up losing a drumstick. And just so happened that it hit one of the guys in the audience straight in the forehead.
Oh my god.
So that was one, and the second one that actually just popped in my head was something that definitely gave me a workout, because my double bass pedal decided to break.
Oh god.
In the middle of the set. And it wasn't something that I can just quickly fix, so I kind of had to make do with only one leg. So,
trying to do double bass with one?
Yeah.
Nice.
Still pulled it off, but I think my leg died at the end.
One of your legs now bigger than the other?
Nope.
Okay.
That's not his leg.
And you would know, Ed.
Yes, I would.
Oh, man.
Hey, what goes on at practice stays at practice.
This is when Melissa isn't there.
I had no idea about this.
Ed, what you got?
Well, you know, it's hard to top the one that Izzy already told, because that one is a classic. I think probably playing a show where the singer forgot lyrics to two songs and didn't even try to fake it. Just kind of stood there. I shot him an angry look, and he just kind of looked at me, shrugged his shoulders like, oh, well, what am I going to do?
actually, if I still had the video of me, Ed, and another guitar player, all three of us in sync, just looked at this poor guy at the same time. When it was his lyrics, his songs. He went in, silence. All of a sudden, you see the three of us. Doom, just like lasers on him, like, dude, what the hell's going on?
And did he just have, did he have lasers would have just
stage fright, or he just didn't remember his?
It was the last song.
Oh,
it wasn't like, you know, not even the opening track. It was the last song.
He made it through most of the
How
song.
Had he done up to that point?
Decent.
Decent.
Yeah.
Failed.
Yeah. Miserably, I might add.
So after that show, he was no more.
No.
Oh, man. Pressure's on.
Now, Melissa, since you don't have an embarrassing band live moment,
oh, no.
Give us an embarrassing moment in the life of Melissa. Anything.
Every day.
That Metro story a couple of weeks ago was entertaining.
Oh, with the...
The photographer.
Oh, man.
I feel like we need the music to
what happened for this. And then this song starts up again.
Well, no,
please
just,
tell us.
Just a random guy wanted me to go so he could photograph me.
And that's
and you
how
said
rape
yes,
happens.
Of course, right?
I said no, I'm not interested in that. But there was actually last weekend I messed up the train schedule and was getting fed beer by some random guy. Here, have beer, beer, beer.
That's
and
how rape happens again. You are not watching these warning signs. Metro's
the warning signs are there.
We're having this like random conversation, and apparently one of the other people on the train was recording it.
Oh my god!
And going to put it on YouTube.
What?
Yeah.
What were you talking about?
All sorts of stuff.
She
I
gave out her home address
towards
you know?
The end. And, yeah, one of the guys started calling everybody on the train blowjobs. So the guy was going to call the YouTube video blowjobs on trains.
Oh,
so somehow
so
she made it
I'm
in the porno last weekend.
To see if it's even
oh, jeez.
On there.
You
I
had strange pictures
like,
taken
oh.
on the train of you.
There were there's no actual blowjobs going on. Let
somewhere on
that.
The internet, there's pictures of her now on a metro.
Talking about BJs.
Mentioned
you're,
in a blowjob
no,
video.
I was being called a BJ.
Oh.
And then he called everybody on the train. You're all blowjobs.
How do they like, that doesn't make any sense!
Oh, God.
But I love Metro Violence on YouTube. Some of those people are just unruly for no good reason. Especially on those quiet trains. People will get violent if you're talking.
Oh, man.
I hate the quiet cars. That's the dumbest fucking thing I've ever heard. You can't use your cell phones. What am
sir,
I saying?
Sir, you need to leave. Sir,
like I can't play
sir,
Candy
this is a quiet car.
I get yelled at for my headphones being too loud. Like,
wait, really? They're literally, they're supposed to be quiet.
Yeah, yes. Quiet cars for
that's
the nighttime.
A thing. I thought you meant they're just supposed to just
no.
kind of.
There's
be
signs
quiet.
Posted saying quiet car, you cannot
picture?
Talk on cell phones. Yeah,
I
very
always
angry.
Want to draw like a little line on the finger because it looks like
my
people.
Goodness.
People have said, can you look at the picture?
The picture of the quiet car, it's like a picture of somebody saying, shh, put the finger like. It's just,
so you want to draw testicles on is what you're trying to say.
You can't say penis. It's
I
okay.
do. I want to make it look like a penis. And draw, like I refrain.
This damn penis bandit keeps drawing all over our quiet signs.
Could you imagine though if you did that and someone was talking, they said, "Sir, this is a quiet car. Look at the side," and then all of a sudden he whips it out.
You're in the blowjob car now.
Or even better, they say, look at the sign, and you walk over to it and draw it into a penis and say, look at the sign now. What? And then walk off or something. I don't know.
It's the penis train.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Why isn't your wiener out? We're on the penis train.
Awesome. Let's go ahead and play another track before local roundup that you guys have brought, because I know you graciously burned two full CDs. Of
if you want to.
Playlist.
Yes, no, maybe, so, maybe, huh?
All right, so let's play one of those songs
so,
on the CD.
I got to throw a nod to my favorite band ever, Iced Earth, Pure Evil.
Dave, do you know where that is
he's
on there?
He's searching for it. Slowly.
Yeah, I got it. I just making sure I had the right track because they're just numbered. They're not actually
it's
like.
It's always an issue. There's always something.
There's always some fucking excuse, Dave.
Exactly, so just Iced Earth?
Yes.
Oh, Dave.
Happy birthday, you fuck.
Someone started the party early.
Yeah, Dave.
No, that's a track. Season one, track 18.
Always excuse. Are you what
counting?
Aren't there numbers next to it?
Oh man!
It's the play.
Steve jumped so hard.
It's not it.
I'm going off of the numbers of the goddamn list here.
Are you looking at the right disc?
Yeah, disc one, right?
Is disc one in the player?
Yeah, no, I ripped it all out.
Oh
yeah.
My God. This is terrible.
Well, let's just skim through them really quick until we find it.
We'll just really quickly just play everything.
Well, just take it off YouTube or something. I mean, if it's going to be this much of a hassle for you.
Then screw it. Just do it.
Happy birthday!
I'm so sorry. This is so embarrassing. Usually our sound guy is a little bit more prepared for this.
Happy birthday.
This mixed CD comes as a shock because no other band has done this.
There we go.
Thank you, Dave. We'll be right back.
listening to The Metal Experience. Only on Slam Internet Radio.
Well, we finally got it. This is The Metal Experience with Threatening the Order. And it took a while, thanks to Dave and some I can't read a piece of paper bullshit, but that's okay. Dave,
happy birthday!
The point is, he tried really hard.
The point is, yeah, he tried, and you know, he's another year or older, and another year getting closer to dyslexia.
I like how when Liz-dexia? You said that, you fucking, you know, that word.
Is she Liz-dexic?
Yeah, probably.
I'm not dyslexic.
Liz-dexic, get it? Because
I mean, I've just
around.
Got a speech impediment sometimes when I talk about.
So anyway, Dave,
Armageddon.
Good job.
Right, Morgan?
I can't hear you. Oh, yeah. I'm not wearing headphones.
He said Armageddon.
Armageddon?
She pronounced Def Leppard song. She pronounced it like an asshole.
Armageddon. It took me a while. I pronounce things differently. I say railroad. I don't know.
Well, anyway, moving on. Thanks for that insight into the life and speech impediment
How
of Morgan.
How dumb I am in my head. It's okay. It happens on a daily basis. I apologize, folks.
All right. Awkward. So,
Well, how many years did it take before I can say Master Choli?
Master Choli.
I think it just happened.
You just said it for the first time? Oh, my God.
Congrats.
Metal Experience is making people become
smarter
people.
I used to say Mosta Choli.
Mosta Choli.
Before that, you said Muscatoli.
Muscatoli.
I forgot all about that one.
That's awesome, though. You know, it's nice to have your own language.
It's nice that Morgan helps other people with the English language. Good job, Morgan.
I like how my dumbness makes other people smarter and can pronounce things, and then I just get worse.
Anyway, moving on. This is. I don't know. Thanks, Dave.
I don't know what just happened. I don't have headphones.
It was the
More you know.
The more you know, yeah.
The what now?
Anyway.
All right. Well, anyway, we are sitting here with Threatening Disorder.
Threatening the Order.
Threatening What did I say?
Disorder.
Oh.
You have a disorder.
Oh, it's been a long day. It really has. I wasn't
Threatening
feeling
the Disorder
well
would make an awesome Christian
Maybe
metal
this
band,
is
though.
Why. I just had a bad feeling when I woke up this morning. Oh, I talk too much. Okay, so Threatening the Order has been with us, and we played two tracks that you guys are going to get mastered eventually, but you guys did play them.
Give us, you know, a couple of months, and we'll have it done.
But it was awesome that you guys thank your sound engineer, or I don't know who said that to you, your producer, sound engineer? Who sent those
Dave?
Tracks? Dave. Dave.
A different Dave.
It was a different Dave.
Like, Dave, what?
Thanks, other Dave.
Thanks, other Dave. For anybody looking for recording, what was that studio again that you recorded at?
It's called Demented Records. The best way to actually get a hold of them is just go on Facebook.
Okay, Demented Records. Look for them on Facebook. And then, again, for that show coming up on the 14th, what are some of those details that you know about it?
I think I just heard a click. But okay. It is December 14th. We are playing at Bada Brew in Joliet,
Crest
Illinois.
Crest Hill,
Illinois.
Which is across
Joliet.
The street from Joliet.
Yeah, right down the street.
So if you go to Joliet and you see Bada Brew on the other side, we're going to be there. The show starts at 8:30. Ideally, we would love to see people getting there around 8 because that's when the doors open. Same thing, like I said before. Well, you do want a demo,
the doors necessarily open. It is a bar. You can't.
Well, it is like, a bar. The doors open for the show.
Right. So come there at 3 in the afternoon if you want.
There you go.
Yeah, be there at 3.
Be there
by
8 or 8.
So, like I said before, if you do want a demo, just do talk to one of us.
Just stare at them and say hi.
Or you can just stare at us, say hi when we're
on stage. And you guys will know what they're doing, right?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Perfect. When we're on stage, just kind of like wave.
Depending on what they look like.
Just wave, or if anything, try and punch Melissa.
What? Why would you punch her?
Why not? It'll be her experience.
Are you promoting
her first
It'll be
abuse
her
on
experience.
Women?
No.
Oh, yeah.
Women on women abuse.
If you are a woman, feel free to punch
her
singer.
Do you
want to
see her kill somebody?
I'm going for the first experience.
I'm really hardcore, so.
See, there you go. She might punch back.
I mean, she is wearing a dying fetus hoodie.
She might
punch
back.
That she stole from her child.
Yep. Ripped it out of his
I
hand.
Steal shit from kids.
Fuck yeah.
But like I said, if you do want a demo, it is at a low price of free.
All right, and with that, let's do local roundup.
Dave.
The local roundup with Morgan on the Metal Experience. I think that's my cue. I can't hear it, but I'm pretty sure it's just music. No, it's fine. It's fine. I'm talking. All right, so coming up, we've got some shows at Another Hole in the Wall looking for bands to play, so hit them up if you are interested in playing. Starting with Norma Jean on November 30th. This is this coming weekend. They're looking for a couple bands. And Kissing Candace on December 6th. So hit up Darlene at exonlive.com, and there's also more shows posted if they're interested. Also check out these bands that are in need of new members. Hailstorm Annihilation still needs a bass player. They are getting ready to hit Europe on tour with 6 Feet Under in December, so definitely check them out if you're a bass player. And also Return to Flesh, also looking for a bass player. So if you're a bassist, there's two opportunities for you. Biomimic, they were on a couple weeks ago. They are still looking for a keyboard player. And so check them out on their Facebook page.
They actually have a website that you can find from
on the Metal Experience page. So everybody that's been on our show, everybody that we just mentioned, you can find them all on the Metal Experience website, and that'd be easy for you to get in contact with them from that. MHX Radio, shout out to them. We actually went to their Toy for Tots benefit last night, and holy shit, there were so many donations.
Oh, man.
Some guy came in a truck, I think his name was Dan, showed up, and he had his back of his pickup full of toys and donations, and
not just the back,
like the pickup back, and then the back seat of the truck and the front seat. So it was just all full of donations from the Melrose Park Toys R Us. Thank you so much.
Funny story about that. When we were getting some toys for the tots to donate, Morgan grabs black Barbie doll, and she's like,
oh,
"I'm
man.
Gonna get this for."
Don't do this.
I was like, "Yeah." Black Barbie doll!
I don't know if it would have been weird.
Yeah, I don't know if there'd be like some little white girl would be like, I don't want black Barbie doll!
It was a black mermaid, okay? It was just a little awkward.
You're such a racist, Morgan!
I don't know. It's just I don't know what these kids are going to think. I don't know what toys they're going to like, and I just decided against it because I didn't want to make assumptions. I'm sorry, okay? I'm not perfect. I'm just trying to find the best gift for a child.
It's going to be that one little girl that's like, I wish I had black Barbie doll.
Oh my God, this is awkward.
Just remember that hate is taught.
Okay. Well, with that, thank you, Dustin, for your Toy for Dots benefit. I'm sorry I failed you and didn't get the black Barbie doll.
All right, come on, you can do this.
But we interviewed, and it was awesome to talk a little bit on MHX Radio, which we've never done live before. We saw a lot of great people. Dozer and T-Rex were there. I'm sorry we missed Corey. She wasn't there when we were there, but she showed up later. Steve from Marauder was there. And then there was also Kimmy from the Metal Deli was supposed to be there, but she didn't feel well, so I hope you're feeling better. And then Frank and Gibby, Orion 9 and RNG Productions team, they were there. So it was nice seeing everybody and seeing all the donations. It was definitely a great cause to be a part of, and we can't wait till next year. MHX Radio, though, throughout the week does shows Dozer and T-Rex from 8 to 11 on Monday nights, The Doom Cellar with Dozer from 8 to 10. And Thursdays, Dustin's still working on putting together his show, so that'll be coming back soon, hopefully. But also throughout the week, they broadcast the Metal Deli with Kimmy, and then Corey Rocks Your World. We get rebroadcast on Friday nights from 7 to 9, followed by Neil's War Mouth, and then Neil's Metal Mouth, and then Corey Rocks Your World is on after that. Also, the upcoming shows this week, Wednesday, November 27th, that's tomorrow, at the Fallout in Chicago at 7 p.m., $10, 21 and up to see Beyond Death. They'll be on our show January 28th. What? Savagery, Pig Champion, Texas Toast Chainsaw Massacre,
yeah.
Predator, and Viscient. Tomorrow at Penny Row Pub, 7 p.m., $10, 21 and up to see Damage Justice, Hangar 18, Freak on a Leash, and ADHD.
When is that?
Tomorrow. Okay. Tomorrow at Cobra Lounge, 21 and up, 8 p.m. to see Among the Living, the Anthrax tribute. Metal Up Your Ass, which is Armored Assault as Metallica. Slave New World.
Metallica
the
tribute.
Yes. Sepultura cover, and then Hell Awaits.
Tribute.
You want to read this?
We're not a cover band, all right? We're a tribute
Slayer
band, okay?
Tribute. Oh, my God. Tomorrow, here's an address for you all for all ages. It's $5, 6 p.m. to go to 41... 4144 West 25th Street. Again, that's 4144 West 25th Street. And Kedval, it's Jurassic Park in Chicago. Apparently, that's what they call this residence, Jurassic Park. So they are going to be having Nameless Motive, Savagery, Human Stew, Death Sentence, Damnation, Self-Medicated, and Foreign Policy playing. Wednesday at the Live Wire, 21 up, $5, 10 p.m. to see Sinister Fate, Cosmic Fury, and Cobalt Core. Online on Friday, November 29th, on fear.net, Beauty in the Suffering is releasing their music video for their song The Crazies, which is their zombie video. Check it out. It gets released on Friday. Friday at the Livewire Lounge in Chicago, 8 p.m. It's $5 with non-perishable food donation. 21 and up, it's Punksgiving Day 1. You can see Light the Fuse, This Obsession, Solution Unsatisfactory, The Kreutzer, Sonata, and Blast Off. On Saturday, November 30th, at Capital Center Sports Bar in Appleton, Wisconsin, $5, 5 p.m. to see Second to Fall, Grave Remains, Intercorpse, Vile Disgorgement, Eternal Silence, Johnny Cage, Screaming Entombment, Burial Ritual, and Decivilize.
This Johnny Cage band is playing a ton of shows.
Saturday at Another Hole in the Wall in Steger, it's $14 in advance, $16 at door, all ages, 5:30 p.m. to see From Summer to Fall, Evelyn, Unforgiven Enemy, The Greenery, Ken Mode, Vanna, and Norma Jean. Saturday at Bada Brew, 21 and up, 6 p.m. It's the Tornado Relief Benefit. Bleed for the Fallen, Covered in Thrash, False Hope Fades, and Sons of Serenity are playing. Saturday at Just Bill's Place in Overland, Missouri, $5, 18 and up, 6 p.m. to see Gutter Spike, Sons of Vulcan, Days of Redemption, Annihilate the Hero, and Viricide. On Saturday at Brower House, 21 and up, 8 p.m., $5 to see Cranial Decay, Carpathian Funeral, Radiation Sickness, Against the Plagues, and
you want to do it?
Rotrevor?
What?
Rotrevor?
Spell it.
Rotrevore.
All right.
Good luck. Saturday at the Mutiny in Chicago, 21 and up, it's free. It's Punksgiving Day 2. Street Fist, Sub X, they're from Ohio. Flatcast and The Riot. Are you okay?
I was getting the last ice cube out of the bottom of the cup. That last one's always a bastard.
I worry about you. Sunday, December 1st at Reggie's. It's $10 in advance, $12 day of, all ages to see Bleed for the Fallen. Playtime with Chef, Jimmy Carter, Make It to Midnight, Adelaide, Rocket Surgery, totally. Jack B. Nimble, Tree Culture, Oceanborn, and Tree Caldera.
Tree Culture.
This is the
like
battle
it.
Of the bands. Vote for your favorite name. Sunday at the Doghouse in Lake Station, Indiana. $5 p.m., $8. It's limited admission. ABC Gun.
Limited admission? Yeah. What?
I mean, it's a small place, so they're only allowing...
Where is it at?
It's in Lake Station, Indiana, at the Doghouse. So if it's in a doghouse, I mean, you're not going to get very many people except
like
for like one head.
Two.
ABC Gum, Man the Machine, Ruthless.
I love some of these
band Face
names.
Value, Corkscrew, and The Greenery. At the Elbow Room on Sunday, it's free before 7, $5 after. It's 21 and up to see Geth Prime. They'll be on our show December 17th. Pig Champion, Wild Bunch, and Count Rugen. And then Sunday at Reggie's, $7, 21 and up. 7 p.m. to see King Hiss, The Midnight Ghost Train, and Pale Horseman. And then, Dave, I don't know the details on it, but Casualties are playing tomorrow at Reggie's, correct?
Yeah, they are playing tomorrow.
Who are they playing with? Do you know those?
They're actually playing with Negative Approach, a big hardcore band from the 80s. They're playing with my buddy's band, Fighting for Scraps, and they're also playing with... shit, I'm just going to bug me now. I had the flyer up earlier.
All right. And while he looks that up, next week we're going to have Seconds to Serenity on our show. That's December
3rd. Serenity?
Seconds to Serenity.
Oh, Serenity. Okay. Yes. Yeah, you mispronounced that.
Probably.
Seconds to
Serenity. They'll be on next week. And then after that, on December 10th, we're going to have a very special show. Justin from MHX Radio is going to be here. Corey from Corey Rocks Your World on Sonic Asylum Radio will be here. And then Kimmy from the Metal Deli will be joining us. So we'll have a whole bunch of radio show hosts in here talking probably about the summary of the whole year, because we only have 3 shows after this week before it's the end of the year for us, because obviously we're not going to do a show on Christmas Eve and New Year's Eve. That'd be terrible for the world because we'd probably be wasted. So we're going to leave the drinking and driving part non-existent, so we're probably going to just...
No, it's going to be existent.
You drink, you drive, you spill, Luco.
You put a MAD sticker on the back of my car. I apparently support Mothers Against Drunk Driving now. Yeah. On the back of my car, he put a magnet.
I found it, one of those Mothers Against Drunk Driving
I look
magnets.
Like a loser
found it. We
now,
put it
in
the back of
my
car.
Do you know they're also against, like, rock music?
What?
They're weird like that. Mothers Against Drunk Driving is also, like, very, like, anti-metal music.
Satan music.
Well, guess
know.
What? Now it's a joke in itself because... I'll just say it's metal against drunk driving.
Sweet, actually.
Just be like, I do a radio show for metal. It's metal against drunk driving. I don't support it.
Could be a member of Damn, Drunks Against Mad Mothers.
That's awesome.
By Jaeger.
Yeah, right?
Where's Daddy?
All right, Dave, what is that?
So the lineup, I'm looking at the flyer here. It says Casualty's going to be headlining. Opening up is going to be Last False Hope. I guess it was supposed to be War Torn, but... Fighting for Scraps spilled in that spot, and like I said, Last False Hope, who is a very odd mix of a band. They are like a bluegrass punk band.
All right.
That sounds like fun.
Well, thank you so much for all that info, Dave, and thank you to Threatening the Order for coming on and sharing their new music.
Thanks for having us.
Again, announce that show and where people can find you.
And who else is playing on that bill with you guys?
December 14th at the Bada Brew in Crest Hill with Wicked Deception...
The Complex Project.
There's one more.
And Dark Entropy.
Entropy.
Dark Entropy.
All right, and that starts at 8:30, but they want you there at 8. Do you know how much the cover is?
$5.
$5. That's not bad at all. So that's December 14th, a Saturday. Where can people find you guys? We'll also have a link up this week, too, for our website to link you guys. So
it's
where
already
people...
up.
Oh, it's
I
already
put it up.
Up
today.
Where can we find you guys?
But just in case, facebook.com/threateningtheorder.
And that's awesome. So we definitely will be a lookout for you guys coming up for your new music and then for more upcoming shows. And Dave, we've got a song from This Divided World. Thank you for calling in, Micah, and let us know the update on all that This Divided World has been doing. What is the track that you have chosen called off the new EP?
I picked Curb Stomp the Devil.
All right. Well, here we go. Good night, and we'll see you next week.